Today in this video, we'll learn everything about UTM projection and grid coordinate system. So let's start today's lesson. If you remember correctly, in my previous video, I have showed you that in Mercator projection, you put a cylindrical paper on top of a globe. The globe sits straight. Okay, that's a Mercator projection. And in this projection, if you watch clearly, only the equatorial parts are touching the globe and nothing else, not the other parts, only the equatorial parts are touching the globe. Now, Universal Transverse Mercator, we do the same thing but a little differently. We turn the cylinder 90 degree and we put the globe in. And by doing that, you will see now the globe is being touched from pole to pole, not the equatorial region, right? So what we can do, you can see that this is a position where the globe is touching the cylinder, and we take a thin slice of the globe, okay? And then we can rotate the globe a little bit, or the rotate the paper, rotate the cylinder little bit, take another slice. This looks similar to this what I have shown you in my last video, right? The orange peel. You take a slice of the globe and then you arrange it to have a UTM projection. Now in UTM projection, you have to make 60 such slices, okay? Remember, a globe is 360 degree. If you make a 60 slices, then each slice will be 6 degrees apart. Each slice is 6 degrees apart, okay? So we have 60 slices and we have a 0 degree latitude or the equator at the center line, and we have a prime meridian. Now the prime meridian is not going through any of these slices. Now for correctness, these slices are called zones. So in UTM projection, there are 60 such zones. And the prime meridian is not going through any of the zone. It is coming into the zone boundary. So these are all the zone boundaries at the edge of the orange peel. And they are the zone boundaries. So where does this zone start from? We know that we have a prime meridian 0 degree longitude, but the zone numbering does not start from the prime meridian. It starts further to the west. If you cut an orange from pole to pole in half, there will be an eastern half and there will be a western half. There will be 180 degree on the western half and 180 degree in the eastern half. So this is my west and this is my east. Okay? So in the west zone, it starts from 180 degree west to 174 degree west. And that becomes my zone number 1. And zone number 60 will be 174 degree east to 180 degree east. And that will be my zone number 60. And the prime meridian 0 longitude comes directly in between the zones 30 and 31. So this is UTM projection. It's looking nice, right? Let's put it back onto the chalkboard and see more details about it. Now on the chalkboard, I have drawn some of the zones. As I told you before, it starts from 180 degree west to 174 degree west. And it ends at 174 degree east to 180 degree east. That is the extent of the UTM projection zone numbers. So these are slices. But there is one thing that we must know. The UTM projection does not work beyond 80 degrees south and 80 degrees north. That's the cutoff point. Now, problem is there are some countries like Russia, Canada, Finland, Greenland, they are coming beyond the 80 degrees north. So, they have asked to be included in the UTM projection. So, officially, UTM projection runs from 80 degrees south to 84 degrees north. Now, what are these slices and what it has to do with the grid coordinate system? Let's rub it off and we'll put a single zone into the screen. Now, this is one single zone that I have put in the chalkboard. This is my equator and this is one of the zones, one of the orange peel, one of the slices of the earth. Okay? But we know that this is 6 degrees, okay, and the degree minute second comes from the geographical coordinate system. If you haven't seen my previous video on latitude longitude, then you can see it here. Okay, here we are not talking anything about the degree minute second. We have to convert it into a grid coordinate system. So how do we do it? We draw a center line exactly at the center of the zone boundaries. Okay, remember all these boundaries, they are the meridians and they are the longitude lines. Okay, they all are the meridians. The prime meridian can be somewhere different. It doesn't matter where is the prime meridian. All that matters is my zone boundaries and they are the meridians, and we got a center line and we call it Central Meridian or CM. We got a Central Meridian, okay? And we give it this boundary. We give this a number, an arbitrary number, 500,000. Okay? We give this a 500,000. Remember, this is east and this is west. So if I go 10 meters to the east, there will be 10 meter plus to this number. So my position here, 10 meters to the east, will be 500,000 and 10. Okay, if I go 10 meter this side, then this will be minus 10 meter from the 500,000. Now 500,000 is an arbitrary number, but it is calculated so that when you reach the zone boundary, it does not go, first of all, it does not go into any negative number and it does not go below 6 digit. So it will always remain as a 6 digit. And if you go towards the east, it will increase and it will remain at 6 digit. Okay, so that's the arbitrary number. Now in the grid coordinate system, we always take equator as 0 degree. Okay, 0 degree, and here in grid also it is 0. So if you rise 1 kilometer towards the north, then your this coordinate will be 1000. They all are in metric system. Okay, it will be 1000. So if I am somewhere here 1 kilometer towards north and 1 kilometer towards east, then my coordinate will be 50,1000, and 1 kilometer to the north, my northing will be 1000. Now northing can be in any digit. It can be in a single digit, it can be in a 7 digit. Okay, and that's how the grid system works. If you want to know more about it, then I got a video, you can watch it right here. I have discussed about it more detailed in this video. Now there will be some questions that if my survey area is not within the zone and if I have to cross the zone boundary, then what is going to be my grid coordinates? Okay, so for that matter, remember all the zones have a central meridian. all the zones have a central meridian and whose number is 500,000. Okay, and your equator is zero. So if you are working within this zone number, whatever is your coordinate, the exact same coordinate can be at 60 different places in the northern hemisphere. Okay, your coordinate system does not have any meaning without the zone number. So these are the zone numbers from 1 to 60. Okay, you have to mention your zone numbers when you are writing down a coordinate system. Suppose you are working in this area where your survey area is crossing over to two different zones. Okay, here you can do two different things. One thing is that you can divide your survey area by half and then overlap it and do it in two different zone numbers. That will be the best way to move ahead. Or if the area on the other zone is shorter, you can use the same zone numbers and carry forward to the next zone. Only thing that you have to remember that the easting number does not cross to 7 digit. So when you are working between the two zones, the westernmost point of your zone number will be something like 138000, something like that. And as soon as you are crossing over to the next zone, that will be your eastern boundary of your next zone. So this zone number, when you are entering here, your number, your easting number is going to be about 839000 or something like that, very close. I can't remember the exact thing. So again, when you come to this point, you will see your easting becomes 500,000. And when you come to this zone boundary again, your easting number is going to be 138000. Okay, so the easting and northing of any zone number, any point on a zone number in the northern hemisphere can be at 60 different zones. So now, some of you may ask that where is my north? Let me show you my orange hill. When it is in the orange, you know that there is a north. Okay, but when you peel it, this all top portions were at one time was connected to the north, and all the southern tips, they were connected to the south. So where is north when you make it flat? So in a grid system, everything moving straight up is north. Let me draw that in a chalkboard so that you can understand better. So these are your UTM zones. At one time, all these points were connected to the North Pole. Now, by the virtue of UTM zone, they are now far apart. So where is my north in a grid coordinate system? See, the north is always up. This line directs towards north. This line directs towards north. This line directs towards north. This is north, and everything points towards north. Okay? So all this are directing, pointing towards the grid north. Now I have a video discussing about grid north and true north. If you want to know more about it, I suggest you should see this next video moving ahead. So that's all for today, friends. If you have learned something new today, please give this video a thumbs up and share with the like-minded people. Be good, stay safe, and always be curious.